The Philippines will soon add to its COVID treatment arsenal as it prepares to receive its first shipment of Merck's antiviral pill, molnupiravir. Delivery, which is expected next month, will be good for 300,000 patients with mild to moderate COVID-19. No price for molnupiravir has been announced, but the local distributor says it will be much cheaper compared to prices overseas.
It will be quite affordable. Let's wait for that final cost of importation and what could be that figure. Wendy is asking for an estimate. It's probably anywhere between 100 to 130 pesos per pill.
Meanwhile, Merck has signed a licensing agreement with the United Nations-backed Medicines Patent Pool. This will allow more companies to manufacture generic versions of its experimental oral drug. Merck says the royalty-free license would apply to 105 low- and middle-income countries. Molnupiravir is designed to prevent the replication of the virus that causes COVID-19 inside a patient's body. The Philippines receives nearly a million more doses of Pfizer's COVID-19 vaccine. The government-procured shots arrive in the country Wednesday evening. Vaccine Chief Carlito Galvez Jr. says most of those jabs will be allocated to minors. So far, over 26.1 million Filipinos have been fully vaccinated against COVID-19.
The Philippines will begin its nationwide COVID-19 vaccination of minors next week, starting November 3rd. Children aged 12 to 17 will be able to receive either Pfizer or Moderna's COVID jabs. This comes after more than 2 weeks since the government launched its pilot implementation of pediatric inoculations. So far, over 18,600 minors with comorbidities have been vaccinated.
Until now, we never heard any major adverse effect. We have more than enough supply for our children, at saka na nakita natin na mabuto tayo ng 42 million sa ating warehouses at saka mga storage natin. And we have enough deliveries coming in.
The government plans to vaccinate 12.7 million Filipino children by December. To achieve this, Galvez says the private sector will also be allowed to use the Moderna shots it procured for the children of employees. The Interior Department, meanwhile, tells local officials to consider expanding inoculation hours and augmenting their vaccination teams.
Ang ating mga local chief executives at kanilang mga department heads na magpapabaya or indifferent or meron pong unjustified failure para i-ramp up ang pagbabakuna sa kanilang mga lugar o kaya naman nasiraan ng bakuna, no? Dahil nagkaroon ng vaccine wastage, ay pwede pong maharap sa mga kasong neglect of duty or kaya naman misconduct.
The Philippines again at the bottom of Bloomberg's COVID resilience ranking. This is the second month in a row that the country placed dead last among 53 countries. Bloomberg cited nearly the same factors as last time, the country's low vaccine coverage and continued pandemic restrictions. But there is a bright side. Bloomberg noted the decreasing number of new COVID cases in the Philippines is a positive development that could pave the way for more economic reopening. The global ranking is based on 12 data points spanning from virus containment, vaccination coverage, to overall mortality and progress toward restarting travel. The Philippines has consistently ranked near the bottom of Bloomberg's COVID index, which the government said was unfair. But it also said it was not surprised with the ranking as it placed the blame on rich nations hoarding vaccine supplies.
The Philippines logged 3,218 COVID infections Wednesday, below a single-day tally since May 23rd. The number of active cases has gone down further to 50,000 after over 6,000 patients were tagged as recovered. Meanwhile, 271 more patients have died. The 7.6% positivity rate reported today is the lowest since March 1. The Philippine Environment Department admits it may not be able to do contact tracing on those who visited the Dolomite Beach in Manila Bay over the weekend. An estimated 121,000 people went there just last Sunday, resulting in a breach of health protocols. Health officials earlier raised fears it could become a COVID-19 super spreader event. But Environment Undersecretary Jonas Leones is optimistic this won't be the case.
kahit gustuhin namin na i-trace lahat yung 121,000, parang mahirap pa kami. But of course, what we did during that time is that ang ginawa na lang namin dyan, we strictly implement, we strictly observe the health protocols. With that strategy, we are optimistic, we're confident that at least wala namang nahawa masyado dun sa ano. I hope, we hope and pray that wala namang nahawa dun sa...
The Environment Department has since fired Jacob Memban, the official in charge of supervising activities at Manila's controversial man-made beach. He will be replaced by retired General Ruel Zorrilla. As for Manila Mayor Isko Moreno's suggestion to file a case against the DENR, here's what Undersecretary Leones had to say.
We leave to the IETF. We welcome any investigation. We will inform them what actions did we take during that situation. So we're not evading any investigations regarding this occurrence.